Big Bonino, there's a shot by Mata and a nice leg save. And Ole Mata got knocked down and he's hurt and there's a penalty on the play and Brooks Orpik is going to get it. Oh, Mata looks woozy.
Yeah, his head hit the ice, I think, when he fell down, Jim. And you could see he's in some trouble. Bonino trying to hold him down. Daly comes in, waits for the trainer. I mentioned the nastiness. It's just the nature of playoff hockey. Once you start getting into game two, the intense matchups, and there's one that, boy, that does not look good for Mata the way he's handling it. Interference is the call on the penalty. Puck was long gone, and oh yeah, right to the button. And for Orpik following through, when he stopped up, he got him right in the elbow, right on the chin, and down he went.
For the oft-injured Mata, he'll have to go to the dressing room for some time here. He had a tough game number one, and Pittsburgh may be down to five defensemen, and it's very early in the
Gilbert for Roenick. He got leveled. Oh, what a hit by Pearson. As Roenick had his head down, he's slow to get up. And the whistle sounds. Jeremy Roenick is on Dream Street right now.
Roenick reaching behind him, and he paid the price. He was had his head down.
There have been some vicious hits in this game, and Roenick with his head down and Richardson with his shoulder into him and flattened him. Well, after the whistle, Roenick, I can't believe, got up from that, but he's in some serious pain, gone over to the bench. He's able to finally get up on his own, but I think he hears the phone ringing.
I don't know, because here's the hit by Tucker. And Kapanen took about 15 seconds to get from just inside the blue line to the bench. Leafs had possession of the puck, so they didn't blow the whistle.
Jeremy Roenick, 44th, that's the fourth career playoff overtime goal in 27 games. Watch this shot. This is a beauty.
Another power play as Steen moves it along for Backes. Oh, Seabrook with a huge hit, and Backes is down, and he is not moving. And Steen comes right after Seabrook. Now Backes is getting up, and he's going to try to come right back at the player that hit him.
I don't think Backes realizes who hit him. And I don't know that he is that right now. Yeah, he just fell down again. He tried to get up on a pure instinct, I think. He's leaning against the boards right away. He's having trouble staying on his feet.
And I think Ray Burley is just trying to calm him down right now.
Well, he's got him by the back of the jersey for more than just calming him down.
Well, the officials are having a discussion about this hit, and how this is called and what it is called is going to be huge for this game and potentially the series.
No penalty called on the play. And Backes went down and was not moving at all.
Just as he turned.
Now the question is does Brent Seabrook leave his feet when he makes contact with the hit? It looks like the right skate is on the ice when he makes contact with David Backes. It looks like that right toe, Brian, is still on the ice.
That's true.
When you go and make those type of hits, you are inevitably going to leave your feet when you make contact. Now, the positioning of the forearm or elbow, where was that when it made contact with David Backes? Again, there was no penalty called on the ice that I saw.
It's principal point of contact to the head.
Yeah, it looked like the shoulder to me may have been the first thing that made contact, but regardless of what part of the body of the hitter makes contact, Brian, you make a good point.
He's in trouble here because it's principal point of contact, and he's on the way up. His feet may be on the ice right when he starts. It's principal point of contact.
Seabrook is being led out of the penalty box and to the dressing room. So that leads you to believe it's going to be a major penalty in a game misconduct for a very important player.
Grossman came over in one of those partial money deals. He came over with Chris Conger's contract for Sam Gagne and a couple of fourth round picks. And a big hit there is Miller. Oh, he's slow to get up. Drew Miller's hurt. He's wobbly. He may not be sure where he is. They're ordering Drew Miller right off the ice. He took a hard hit at the blue line. He's going to have to go to the quiet room. He's in some trouble. two Red Wings down tonight. First Polkinen and now Miller. Watch this hit from Dahlbeck right to the head.
Oh, jeez.
Full shoulder hit, principal point of contact.
With a long shot wide. Turla again. This time he's bumped by Babich. Ronning spins McPhee around. Turla is down and he's hurt as he was hit by Burre. And Shane Turla is still down.
Holy mackerel. I cannot believe that Van Helman did not see this. Turla is out cold. Burre caught him with a shoulder in the jaw. And he does not know where he is. Wait till you see the replay of this. If you missed it the first time, Turla had dished out a couple of hard but clean body checks. Just took a check from Babich. Look at this, elbow right to the head. I will tell you that that will be a piece of video footage that will make it past the viewers and to Brian Burke, a former member of the Vancouver Canucks. Boy, Turla is a tough kid. I can't believe that he is up as quick as he is. He says, you see, Andy, that's a friggin' elbow, he said. He remembered what hit him. I'm amazed that Van Helmont didn't see that. He was right in the corner.
Well, Turla had been very much involved down in the Dallas zone, dishing out a couple of hits. Then he was taken in against the boards by Babich. It almost appeared as though he was coming off the boards after the hit by the Vancouver defenseman in pursuit of Babich and wasn't looking at all for Pavel Burre, who really caught him with an elbow.
And it ain't going to happen. Here comes Burns steamrolling into the Philadelphia zone, but it's swept away. Luke Shen. And then a big hit, fire down, plays carrying on, a flyer's in trouble. They're gonna let play carry on here as Vandevelde is down. Now finally they do. Low play dead. This Vandevelde took a huge hit.
Brent Burns destroyed him. Just destroyed him. And it looked like Chris Vandevelde was lying on the ice not knowing where he was. Jim McCrossin is out taking care of him, but Chris Vandevelde is in a bad way right now.
Yeah, he's in a world of hurt right now, Bill. And he was down and he did not move for a few seconds.
Jim McCrossin and teammates to his aid.
Oh, he's shaky.
Yeah.
Got no legs. I think he's talking to Jim McCrossin, trying to make a case that I'm okay, but his legs are telling a different story. Those are little baby steps he's taken now, and he got hit so hard, he got rocked. Oh, his shoulder.
Oh, it's the ice. Head hit the ice.
Hit the ice, but Burn, yeah. He may have been dazed. I mean, that was right in his jaw.
Yeah,
that's... Chris Vandevelde was, oh my.
Yeah, that's an easy KO right there. I mean, it was shoulder.
And Mitchell will get set to return. The Hawks will be 0-4 tonight on the power play. 0-4, 5-on-3 this season. Mitchell's back out, and what a hit! Oh, he caught Taves, and Taves still down. Rock, breakaway, and it's gonna be wiped out by a response. And this is a real double whammy for Vancouver, because they get robbed of a scoring chance on a clean hit by Willie Mitchell on Jonathan Taves.
Taves came back to the bench, dropped a little bit of an expletive, and said, I had my head down. Well, he got blindsided. This is a clean hit from Willie Mitchell. Mitchell comes out of the penalty box. The Blackhawks pass the puck to Taves, and he has no idea where Mitchell is. Look, Taves is just looking for the puck, and there's no reason for Mitchell to be there except he's coming out of the penalty box. This is a clean hit. Taves goes down. He's at the penalty, or he's at the players' bench here talking to the trainer. You can see him stumble. He's obviously in some distress.